We're back, baby.
Let's do this.
Spider-Man 3. I've been doing this now for nearly 7 years, which is wild.
What the f-?
It feels like I've come such a long way from like having two scenes in Captain America to now leading this film, which has been amazing and a huge privilege. The audition process, it still blows my mind how crazy that whole thing was.
Okay then.
I look back on it and it was definitely the most stressful time of my life because I didn't know whether my life was about to change and I wanted to be able to play this character that I'd grown up loving and admiring.
I don't think it was ever a question about who was going to be it from the first second. He was funny, self-deprecating, innocent, and he had a terrible haircut from some other movie he was doing.
What are you doing?
Tom inhabited the character in a way that I don't think any of us have ever seen before. The passion and the level of depth which he brings to this character and the commitment that he has to it has only increased over the years that we've been making these movies. And his enthusiasm and sense of protecting Peter and exploring different parts of Peter has been unbelievable.
That's what we do.
Right, all right. Who's ready to make a movie? Roll camera. Yeah.
Watching Tom through this journey from the first movie into now has been so rewarding.
The first movie is about Spider-Man really wanting to prove himself to Tony Stark and working so hard to do that that he ends up screwing up and making things a million times worse. Like, that's just exactly how I felt on the first movie. Tom and I both felt the same. Like, where are we? What's going on? This is a crazy opportunity. Let's not screw it up.
This is insane. Look at this thing. Look.
We both grew up together. I don't feel like it was a parental role. I felt like we were all the kids.
What's interesting in the previous films is that he really has been the spider boy.
What about me?
What about you?
What if Mrs. Stark needs me or something, or I don't know, something big goes down.
And this film is about him becoming Spider-Man. It's about him growing up, making his own decisions, and stepping up to the plate as a full-blown Avenger. And it's been really nice to kind of have that dovetail between myself on Spider-Man Homecoming and now who I am and who Peter Parker is in Spider-Man No Way Home.
My name is Peter Parker. And I would like a coffee, please.
Tom is the most impressive actor I've seen work. He can be, on one day, the most emotional person you've ever seen.
We're okay. It's just me and you.
And on the next day, he's the most happy-go-lucky guy.
Happy birthday to you.
He's up there on wires, doing all of his own stunts. So his range is incredible.
Right away, the first scene we shot together, I was just blown away by how good he was in the scene and how generous he was and vulnerable.
Tom Holland has all the pressure on him. We get to just like help him and support him as big brothers, and he's carrying it.
He really sets the tone for the day we're gonna have ahead, but also the movie. He comes on every morning in great spirits and he leads the charge. For someone at his age, to have such a commanding presence on a set is truly incredible.
He's constantly reinventing things, coming up with new ideas, brilliant physical pratfalls and stunts as well. We know he's very gymnastic and athletic, but he's really switched on.
There's a kind of poetry about the way he moves. There's a language to it, which is very rather beautiful.
He's incredibly professional, and he's always giving 150%. He won't stop until a shot looks great or until the emotion of the scene works. He keeps pushing and pushing and pushing.
He will literally go until there is nothing left in his body.
Okay, you okay?
Let me try it again and see if I can get it better.
When we did the shield fight, the last couple of takes when he was fighting Willem, when they called cut, he would just drop to the floor. He was spent. There was nothing left. And the next day, he would come to work and he would be ready to go.
Ready and action!
Oh,
Let's go for the spin.
It just is so incredible to see his passion. That alone is what sets the tone for the leadership of this movie.
I think Tom's gonna make a great director one day. So I'm just excited to see what Tom does next.
I just want to say a massive thank you. I know we're not done, we're only halfway through, but everyone has been amazing so far. We've been safe and been responsible and made this happen. So thank you for being, or leading by example and making this happen. It's amazing. Thanks.
With the villains that are in the film, having the other Spider-Mans there to support me while also finishing off their storylines, it warranted the biggest solo superhero movie that's ever been made. And to be at the front of that was such a privilege. It's also quite daunting. It's quite scary, the way that this story has been told, this accumulation of nearly 20 years worth of cinema coming together for one film. Whether or not this is the end of my Spider-Man journey, if Spider-Man swings off into the sunset now, I'd be happy and content with what I've done. But the weight of me saying goodbye to him really comes across in the film.
Oh, Molly. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you.